All hockey, all the time. You're watching the NHL Network.
They're lifting Vaughn up there on that stretcher. Trying to say which leg it is.
Langlois shifts it off the boards. Bob Vaughn lets it drive. Goes
goal!
He gets it into the near back to the foot.
The Montreal Canadiens have won the Stanley Cup.
We can look nice for Tonelli, the nice for he scores!
The Oilers have won the Stanley Cup.
Time once again to go back into the archives. Welcome to Vintage Games here on the NHL Network. I'm Dan Palmer. Today we look back to May 11th of 1989, the Wales Conference Final between the Philadelphia Flyers and the Montreal Canadiens. This was the second time the teams had met in the conference final in 3 years, and a volatile rivalry filled with physical and sometimes vicious incidents had built up. The Flyers had won the series in 1987, but now the Canadiens were trying to exact revenge and were up 3-2, heading to Philadelphia for what was sure to be a very intense Game 6.
Listen to this crowd. Off the faceoff, the puck comes to Robinson, slides it back over to Rick Green. Green with the return to Robinson. Boy, you add the years these two have been playing together. Not necessarily as a pair, but as defensemen for the Canadiens, and how many big games they've been in against the Flyers, against Quebec. Puck turned along by Bob Gainey. Gainey able to dart away from Al Secord. Brings it back. That off Keane and worked loose by Karkner. Ron Hextall comes out to get it. Hextall firing it around the boards. It went through Secord. Gathered in by Green. And Green lofts one that's off the tip of the glove of Chychrun and slowed enough for Hextall to bang it off the boards along to Rick Tocchet. Tocchet shovels, but it's back checked away by Mike McPhee. McPhee feeds it up the wing to Lemieux. Quick shot went wide. Around it comes for Chelios. Checked off by Secord, the puck out of play, and we get a haul.
Well, already we have seen how tight Montreal wants to play this tonight, and now we got Mike McPhee and Al Secord that came together just inside the Flyers' blue line. And although you got to figure this is going to be a physical hockey game, especially from the Flyers, they took it to the Montreal Canadiens with the body in Game 5 up in Montreal. They're not going to change, especially because they're home. I sure don't think we're going to see many fights, if at all. I don't even know if we'll see one. It depends on the score late in the game. Rick Tocchet is the only change in the lineup for either team. He is back in. He sat out Game 5 with that bad right knee in Montreal 2 nights ago. So he is back in tonight. Craig Berube, as a result, is a scratch for the Flyers. Pat Burns hasn't made a change.
Rick Tocchet was so keyed up during God Bless America, he actually left to go back to Ron Hextall to give him the good luck tap early. Realized what he had done because the song was still on, took his helmet back off again and resumed the pose until it was completely over. He is charged. He watches from the bench as you watch a pass from Skrudland come back out to Ludwig, then across to Chelios. Chelios rammed by Derek Smith, didn't get too much of him as the puck taken by Mark Howe. Then Lemieux and Samuelson glide back into Hextall. This one banged back out and Chelios starts back. His pass is slowed by Poulin. Directed back across and Skrudland tried to feed one for McPhee, but that one tipped loose. Still the Flyers are able to tap it back along and it is Ludwig trying to steer but getting Mark Howe as he wanted to reach McPhee with that pass. A shift change on now for Montreal. Pass worked ahead for Derek Smith, chopped away by McPhee, dumped back along, and here's Jay Well.
Boy, early in this game, for the first 2 minutes, Montreal has had that big neutral zone wall up. Now Samuelson can finally penetrate and dump in.
Good drive by Acton, right on goal, and the rebound went wide from Al Secord. It is Bobby Smith, Tim Kerr. Then it's tapped along, and here's Naslund, faking the drive and watched by Jay Well. Pass is knocked loose by Smith. Cut off by Mats Naslund, stride for stride match by Acton. Flips one in front, and it hit off of the man at the front, Bobby Smith, and is controlled by Hextall.
Going to give you a good look at the Samuelson shot. Watch the puck start to twist to the side. That's how pucks move from left to right. They end up going up on their sides. Patrick Waugh's rebound. He thought he was directing it to a safe area, but Keith Acton was the first guy to the corner, got it right back on him.
Off the tie-up, puck came loose to Terry Karkner. Karkner and Chikrin in the defense. It is Poole in the left wing, Sutter the center, and on the right wing is Scott Mellenby. Now it is Green, dropping it along to the turning stick of Mike Keane, shakes one further, and it's Naslund up with it. Tested by Karkner, and ahead with it comes Scott Mellenby. Mellenby putting a move on, and a backhander flew wide. There'll be a penalty coming up against the Canadiens' delayed call on. Puck given up to Montreal, and the first power play of this game will be coming to the Flyers.
You got to know that a power play goal would go a long way to helping the Flyers get out of the spectrum and get back to Montreal for Game 7. I talked to Paul Holmgren before the game. He said, I'd settle for one. Before this series, the Flyers were 20 for 74 on the power play. They're 0 for 17 in this one. Interference is the call. Bottom of your screen, Bobby Smith interfered with Ron Sutter. So Don Kuharski calls the first penalty of the Montreal Canadiens. And the Flyers, you know, won that game in Montreal in Game 5 without a power play goal, but it's a tough road when that power play doesn't click. This is the longest the Flyers have gone all year without scoring one. Five consecutive games. The longest during the season was between the months of February and March, as February turned into March, where they went three games, so it's been a long time for these guys.
Down in a heap when Tim Kerr gets back up to play and takes the puck. Kerr beats one across, and it ricocheted back over to Pelle Eklund. Eklund watched by Ryan Walter. It is back to Murphy. Has Howe and Gibbs to him. Howe to Murphy again. Closing the gap was Walter, so it's a pass to Howe. Feeds it back off for Kerr. Chelios knocked that one away, and Prop fed it along to Eklund. Bothered by Ludwig, and the Canadiens try to clear but can't. It is off Murphy and back to Eklund. Slides it over to Howe. Aside to Kerr. Tested by Chelios. Rolls it around the rim to Gord Murphy. Little pick set by Eklund, and Murphy able to get some room. Hands back to Howe. Then to Murphy again. Murphy just holds as Walter watches. Now Howe with a drive directed high over the net, as getting a piece of that was Brian Propp. Now it is Carboneau, shorthanded, moving back out with Chelios in a two-on-two. Guy Carboneau controls, chewing up more time off the power play of the Flyers. Carboneau brushes along with Brian Propp, and the penalty clock down to 45 seconds. Here is Murphy, took a hit but got away. Up the wing to Tocchet, then to Propp. Propp couldn't get through the slot as three Canadiens converge. Now it is McBee, banking one along, but pinching to play is Karkner, and he put it right on goal. Fed away by Ludwig, and on the back of the net it stays. There'll be a stoppage.
You know, the Flyers started to get some pressure on their power play in Game 5. They felt that the best pressure in this entire series came in Game 5 on the power play, when Tim Kerr actually didn't get much on a shot and Brian Propp got a rebound. Well, they've kind of picked up where they left off in Montreal. Good move by Brian Propp. Then he has it poked away from him. Mike McPhee turns and tries to get it out, but you can see that the Flyers are all over Montreal on this power play. McPhee dumped it around, but Chelios couldn't get it. And Terry Karkner surprised Patrick Waugh with that one. He just turned and snapped it at him. And you can see why this play has been stopped. The puck is on the back of the net.
Well, Karkner and Chikrin will stay in back. You get a close-up look at Ryan Walter, who will try to win this draw from Bullard. Mellenby and Tocchet are the wingers. Walter out. So Brian Skrudlin will cruise in with 29 seconds to go on the man advantage. Ludwig locks up there with Mike Bullard. Puck finessed away to Skrudlin, and he floats it back down. Here is Hextall. Just a little tap over to Jeff Chikrin. Has Bullard flying by. It is Chikrin firing one off the boards. Chelios chops at it. Doesn't get much. Bob Gainey does. Karkner able to keep with the glove. Terry Karkner cruising, watched by Skrudlin. Karkner bound behind. Couldn't get a little pass over to Mellenby, but gets it back again. Karkner back to Mellenby. Penalty time is up. Mellenby chased off by Chris Chelios. Karkner stops it, and Terry Karkner's pass is tapped back by Bullard along to Chikrin, and it's scaled back in. Roy stops behind. Teams are at full strength now with just over 15 minutes to play in the first period. The shots are 3 for the Flyers, 2 for the Canadiens. And so that must mean last time we checked, the Flyers had 2 before the power play, so they only got 1 during that time.
Misleading, isn't it? They had all kinds of pressure on Montreal. They had a minute and 10 seconds of the 2 minutes attack zone possession time, so the Flyers were in the zone, right? Still only 1 shot on Patrick Roy. That Montreal defense still tight.
Here is Derek Smith back up the wing. Has Poulin breaking. Fires one off of Roy on the loose puck scooped up. And it is Richey going back to get it. Ilka Sinisalo in, and then going into Richey heavily was Derek Smith. Puck picked up by Smith. Dealt right back to the corner. Here's Poulin moving in. Poulin goes hard into the corner with Larry Robinson. Smith in to knock it loose. Now the Canadiens control on defense, and the pass is outletted to Corson. Hands back on to Richey. Flying up the wing, Richey is taken to the boards by Wells. So it is Desjardins back to play. Getting it back again, and then Courtnall has to help out. 13 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the first period. We have no score. It's moved back up now for Desjardins. Rockets it around the boards, and it went off Hextall. Puck picked up, though, and floated out by Carbonneau, and a shot by Robinson skipped into Hextall. He's able to hang on.
For 40 years, the Pittsburgh Penguins have provided some of the NHL's most unforgettable moments. And now you can relive them with the Penguins' 10 Greatest Games box set, as voted on by the fans.
Just moves in towards the goaltender, shoots, and he scores!
Hosted by Mike Lang, the original broadcasts capture all the amazing action.
Oh, you'd have to be here to believe it!
Available wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
In this jersey, I pledge to wreak havoc on my opponent's plus-minus.
To make one-timers happen way more than once.
I pledge that my team will scrap for every single point on the schedule.
In this jersey, I pledge that holes are only holes if they're open.
Shop.nhl.com presents the RBK Edge jersey. All 30 teams reinvented for more strength, more speed, more belief.
In this jersey, I pledge to play for the logo on the front, not the name on the back.
What do you pledge? Visit shop.nhl.com for your jersey.
And the peas.
Come on! Hockey teaches a kid determination, teamwork, and a darn good shot, too. Learn how to get started at onegoal.com, a website sponsored by hockey's leadership companies.
All hockey, all the time. You're watching the NHL Network.
Off the faceoff, it is Skruglund, the backhander on, reading that through the maze of sticks and legs was Hextall. Puck dealt back along to be turned out by Poulin, then he was given a good sandwich to the glass by Skruglund. Puck into the glove of Lemieux, across to the stick of the Flyer Scott Mellenby. Rammed to the boards by Skruglund. Mellenby with a pass that's too far for Poulin, shift change on, brings out Brian Propp. Sutter stays, so does Mellenby to work with Howe and Samuelson. It is Green and Svoboda, the defense combination, playing some catch for the Canadiens. Green lofts, and on the hop, it is read by Scott Mellenby. Teams both have 4 shots, no goals. 7 minutes have been played in this first period. Brian Propp with a shot and getting a piece of it, Roy, and then he covers up to hang on.
Well, the Flyers have the right idea early. Get something at the net and bust by the big Montreal defense for a rebound. It's a lot easier to get around a guy when you don't have to keep the puck with you. And the Flyers have taken a lot of shots from the perimeter, a lot of shots as soon as they've gotten over the blue line. Here's Brian Propp. That's a good play. He's got a one-on-one with one of the best defensive guys in the league, Rick Green. So Propp shoots and then goes to the rebound. That's how close he came to it. That's Brian Propp right there. It's actually a one-on-two because Swoboda, number 25, is back there too. Six shots on Patrick Waugh so far, four rebounds. The Flyers are driving for them, trying to get possession of them.
Boy, he didn't allow that many in either of the shutout. Actually, in any of the Montreal wins, right. I don't think he allowed four rebounds. We've played 7-13 of this first period. Rick Tocchet will move in. Mike Bullard steps to his right. Eklund the other forward with Kartner and Chychrun. No score. Game six. Canadians have the lead in the series. 3-2. It was 3-1. Eklund controlling. Tripped up on the play by Courtnall. Trying to jam it at the front is Bullard. And it is not from Walter, but picked up by Pelle Eklund. Poke checked away from him. And a good play there by Carboneau. Now it is Terry Kartner shoveling it back around the boards, and Roy stops. Chelios didn't get there first. Eklund did, but the Canadians control. Kartner with a drive, and that went off Tocchet. Tries to get loose for a shot and just could not get control. Bullard sandwiched to the boards. The puck tipped back out by Courtnall, and the Canadians realize that the Flyers are throwing a lot at them. They've gotten six shots on goal to Montreal's four, but they've had more of the territorial pressure by a long shot. Here's Kartner with a pass that went off Mike Bullard. Feathered ahead by Courtnall. Stepping along with it is Carboneau, just surrounded by orange and black. But he's able to spin and deal it back in deep. Ekstall sets. Kartner takes. Shift change on for both squads. Sinisalo and Poulin have stepped out to join Kartner as this one fired around and went through the legs of Roy, and he nearly closed off the route for the defenseman Chelios. Spun one that Ludwig didn't see, and the Canadians looking a little flustered just now. Chris Chelios leads the march back up, slides it on back to Ludwig with 11 and a half to go in this first period. Ludwig wraps it around the boards, and Hextall is there to take it. Scoops one along that came right to Bobby Smith. Smith controlling, centers one, but Gord Murphy was right in the way. Murphy tips it along, and it's Derek Smith advancing it up the wing to Sinisalo with Poulin breaking. He gives to him, followed up by Smith, tightly checked off by Keane. Puck swung over toward Murphy, sent to the front by Wells, but cut off and brought back up by Desjardins. And Desjardins over to Mats Naslund. Naslund flips off the tip of the stick of Bobby Smith. He follows up on Murphy and takes him hard to the boards and glass. The two of them get up as you watch Wells play it. It is Desjardins for the Canadiens defense. Virtually non-stop action here in the first period of play. 10 minutes, 50 seconds to go, no score. Pivoting is Robinson. A pass is just floated back out by Tim Kerr. Patrick Roy sets it up and Desjardins takes over. Lays a little pass across, and it is overskated by Robinson, but now he's able to control back to Desjardins and then back ahead to Naslund. Mats Naslund controlling, wanting to worm his way by Samuelson. Good poke check by Samuelson, and he cuts off the route for Naslund as it is now Acton dumping one behind to Mark Howe. It is Howe connecting with Secord. Stiff pass ahead is tipped away. He wanted Acton but got Richie, and it's worked on back to Green. Drops it back for Svoboda as we near the halfway point of this first period of play. Green holds, sets it for Richie. Stefan Richie moving it back out for the Canadians. Big blast, and that one went wide, hit the back of the net, and Samuelson in. Checked off by Corson, but not until he'd released to Kerr. Back up now to Keith Acton, who couldn't control. Canadians drop it back in. Catch a man in the zone, and so we get an offside pass call. 9:43 left in the first. Our game scoreless.
Watch Ovechkin fly like Bure. See Fenner smash like Stevens.
Malkin, sensational!
In a new generation of NHL stars, there are remnants of the past. The Just Like Me DVD shows how a new group of heroes is influenced by hockey's greatest generation.
You want to talk about good young talent?
Available January 22nd wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
Oh, my goodness.
8 minutes into the second period, and the Detroit Red Wings lead the Montreal Canadiens 3-2.
The game has changed. So should the way you watch it. NHL Network, the home of hockey. Available in HD.
Is this the year the cup comes to Buffalo?
To Carolina?
To Pittsburgh?
Is this the year someone scores 50 and 38?
In 37?
In 36? Is this the year someone scores 200 points?
Is this the year kids start taping their sticks like Stahl?
Is this the year someone scores 93?
Is this the year a forward becomes unstoppable?
Is this the year a goalie stops everything?
Is this the year we finally figure out who's dad's favorite?
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
Let it go up.
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
He leads in Stanley Cup appearances tonight, his 218th Stanley Cup playoff game as a linesman. Andy Van Helleman is the leader among referees with just over 150. Finn, 48 years of age, this is his 20th year. Ahead now comes Green. His blast, oh, just sailed over the net and the glove of Hextall to the glass. Poked along by Lemieux. Worked further by McVie. Chops one high, that's knocked down by Sutter. To Mellenby, couldn't tip it by Svoboda. Wrapped back around and Hextall is there. Dumps it off the boards and Brian Propp scoops it ahead, but too far for Sutter.
Boy, that was a quick 3-on-2. Now we got a problem back here in front of Ron Hextall. Don Koharski has called one, but I don't know if it's against Brian Skrudlin or Ron Hextall. Somebody will go. It's a Montreal Canadian, and it is Brian Skrudlin. So the Flyers will get another power play. Right of your screen, Brian Skrudlin runs into Ron Hextall. Hextall holds Brian Skrudlin's stick, but that wasn't called. Skrudlin is off. He just went back and said, hey, that belongs to me. But by then, the penalty had been called, I think.
Hextall in customary fashion for players in the late 80s in the NHL, decided to make it look pretty good too. Here's Murphy flipping one along that plopped near Tim Kerr, forced back down by Walter.
You know, to me there's no question that the Montreal Canadiens are flat and that the Flyers have come out exactly the way they finished off in game 5, and there's a real good reason for that. Montreal doesn't want to be here. The Flyers are saying, all right, we get to go back home. Wow, look at that shot by Mike Bullard. The Flyers say, great, we're back home. Montreal says, I can't believe we let them off the hook. So Montreal has some cobwebs to get out of their heads, and the Flyers are going to crawl all over them. It's to the Flyers' advantage right now.
How wedges, Hextall takes. Penalty time. Down now to 1:05 to Skrudlin. Ahead, steam, Pelly-Ecklin shovels it over to Kerr. Then back to Howe. Howe hands to Murphy. Fires one that ricocheted off Walter. Pivoting with this and shooting it back along, but not out. That time was Chelios. Murphy gets it back across to Ecklin. Pump checked away by Ludwig. Ecklin hands back to Murphy. Chops it over to Kartner. Angles one for Ecklin, but it was too stiff. Now Ecklin once again. Murphy a drive, and that deflected. It went right into the Flyer at the front. Brian Propp, who was leveled by Chelios. Murphy again, deflected. It went wide, and it caught Roy looking first to his left, then to his right. Behind the net, the battle continues. Penalty time is down to 22 seconds. They fidget one to the front, trying to get to it as Kartner. Down to the ice, a Canadian, and ahead with it now is Bob Gainey. Gainey trying to get through, popped one off the glove of Murphy, and it's scooped up by Ecklin as they're down to the last 10 seconds of the power play. Kelly Ecklin moving it ahead, looks for a pass, got it over to Propp. He has to go to the corner to play, and it's jumped off by Chelios. Puck to Ecklin, looks for Kerr, score! It is Mellenby, and it is 1-0.
Mellenby has waited a long time in this series to score one, but I don't think he could have picked a better time for the Flyers than right now. The penalty had expired, so that won't qualify as a power play goal, but the Flyers could care less right now. They draw first blood. The team that has scored first in every game in this series has gone on to win. Beautiful feed from Eklund. He waited for Mellenby to get open. And Mellenby just had to shovel it by Patrick Waugh. So Scott Mellenby scores here. 7-11 to go in the first period. And the Flyers strike first. That has been a key.
The team that has scored first in each of the games of this series has won. Bobby Smith turns it back along to Robinson. Dumps it off the glass and it pops over to Hextall. Second thought wasn't a good one. Samuelson leveled from behind by Bobby Smith. And Samuelson getting up slowly. Puck tapped by Mellenby along to Brian Propp. Loses though, and it is flicked back out by Desjardins. Naslin tries to get by. Pivoting with this is Mellenby. Dumps it back to Howe. Propp tips ahead. Mellenby races on. Offside is called against the Flyers.
In a new generation of NHL stars, there are remnants of the past. The Just Like Me DVD shows how a new group of heroes is influenced by hockey's greatest generation. Available January 22nd wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
All hockey, all the time. You're watching the NHL Network.
Hockey, it's more than a game. For some, it's their faith, their commitment. Less than a religion, but not by much. Refined throughout history, but unchanged in its enduring simplicity. Played by a group of men whose hearts pump life beneath a crest for which they would sacrifice body and soul. It is a ferocious ballet of speed and skill, force and bravery. Beautifully captured in all its splendor on NHL DVDs from Warner Home Entertainment. The history, the legends, the moments, the glory. Own it today.
Now available on DVD, Pittsburgh Penguins' Greatest Game Box Set, the Greatest Stanley Cup Final Game 7s Box Set, Stanley Cup Championship DVDs, and more. Available wherever DVDs are sold and at shop.nhl.com.
A look at the goal from the blimp. Mellenby moved right in front of Patrick Waugh. All he had to do was shovel it home. That has to be a lot of weight off Scott Mellenby's shoulders. He has worked so hard, but really hasn't been able to produce against Montreal goal-wise.
First goal in the series, fourth in the playoffs for Mellenby. Eklund and Propp assist at 12:49. Canadiens tip one along, but Derek Smith is there to get it. Flyers have outshot the Canadiens 9-5. Low shot totals customary in this series. Larry Robinson flips. It is kept by Gord Murphy. Moves it back ahead. Murphy has Derek Smith moving and got it to him, and then Smith is walled right off by Skrudland. Now Robinson trying to control in all that traffic, still able to force his way across, and now lay it on the stick of Claude Lemieux. Then ahead, it went off Skrudland. He's tripped up, and there'll be a penalty coming up, and Jay Wells will go. Montreal's power play will get a chance to work.
Brian Skrudland had about a quarter step on Jay Wells, and Wells hardly touched him. But Skrudland, I guess, in Koharski's mind, made it look good enough. So a long 2 minutes starts for Jay Wells. When you get down to this stage, game six, only four teams left. 2 minutes is an eternity when you're the guy sitting in the box.
Off the tie-up, Richie flipped one across, and it's sent back down by Poulin. Now with that faceoff, Sutter has come off and Propp has joined Poulin. It'll be Howe and Samuelson in back. Canadiens move it ahead and a big blast by Chelios around the roulette wheel, but intercepted by Hextall, though he couldn't control. Richer is there, has it knocked away by Poulin. Richer going back at it, gets it to the point. Here's Svoboda from his knees, scooping it across to Chelios. Chelios flips one and it went off Howe wide. Now Richer, then Corson, pestered by Poulin. Richer gets it back to Svoboda, slides it over to Chelios. Chelios a shot, pad stop, rebound on, Walder shot it wide. It is Svoboda keeping. Handing back for Richer's drive, and that one went off of Brian Prompt. Good Canadian pressure. As it is now only halfway through the power play, and I'm sure to Flyers fans, it seems like it should almost be over. But here is Keane. Keane laying it back out on the stick of Bobby Smith, shuffles one over to Naslund, trying to get by Kartner, and it's wedged right off. Bobby Smith comes by to carry it further. Takes a look and has Naslund moving to the front. Smith creeps in and a backhander knocked down McKean. They score on the rebound and the game is tied.
You know, Mike, I didn't get a very good look at it for some reason, but I didn't seem to see Mike Keane really shooting towards Ron Hextall. Bobby Smith just shoveled to him.
I thought it went off Jeff Chipman. Okay.
Absolutely. Jeff Chipman put that puck in. You can see him grabbing his helmet right there. Mike Keane never did get wood on it. Watch this. Bobby Smith will just try to shovel it in front. And he does get it in front, but Kartner has Keane tied up. Jeff Chychrun moving back, just trying to clear the play. Has a nightmare unfold before him. Now that's going to be a test for the rookie. He's going to have to shake that off and play some strong hockey now. That's a big mistake early in a game, but it's an accidental mistake. And that's something that Jeff Chychrun's going to have to realize. And as soon as he gets to the bench, Paul Holmgren is going to talk to him about it. But, you know, I think Holmgren's making the right move now by leaving him out there. He didn't pull him after that mistake.
Yeah, and the puck went right to him, and he confidently sent it 90 feet right in on Roy. Here's Desjardins. Oh, and a good hit by Chychrun on Corknall. Flipped by Tockett. Tockett tries to follow up. Gets away from the hook check of Walder and headmans it on to Eklund. Tockett breaks. Eklund controls. Pivots and looks, and Samuelson about to arrive, but now the net dislodged, and coming back at Carboneau is talking. I would imagine we were wide enough that some of you who were not following the puck probably looked in the net direction where Tockett was going, but we have plenty of tape machines that'll give us perhaps a replay of this so that we have an idea.
Kelly Eppen was doing a good job of buying time and allowing Rick Tockett to get to the net, but you can see that, well, yeah, you probably couldn't tell from that picture, but you had to figure that Rick Tockett wasn't heading towards the net unassisted. He had Guy Carboneau all over him.
And it's the old wrestling turnbuckle play. If somebody else is in the way, why, maybe you can kind of go right into him too, and I think he brushed into Roy, but all of this has been a concern to officials who feel that a lot of goal-scoring plays are going to be difficult for them to determine whether the puck went in before the net dislodged, because teams are just setting it up that way now. This, of course, did not involve the centering pass. Tremendous response last Friday night. The Flyers are again offering a free Ron Hextall t-shirt with a purchase of a Fighting Back video, $19.95. Now, if you couldn't get through on Friday, the number to call is up there, 215-465-4500. You can call right now. The lines are open. The operators are waiting. And soon you'll have a video plus a Ron Hextall t-shirt. And on the t-shirt will be the dates of the 2 days on which Ron Hextall has scored goals. T-shirt says, lightning strikes once, but Hextall strikes twice. And the X in Hextall are lightning flashes. Here's Carboneau on this faceoff with Acton. And the puck squibbed back, and it is Mark Howe going to get it. In the last 3.5 minutes of the first period of play, our game is tied at one. Bobby Smith gets credit for the goal. Keenan Naslund, the assist at 15:42. And Desjardins able to touch up for the icing. And to touch the puck before a Flyer put it in his own net. So our game is tied here at one, and play will come back on the icing near Ron Hextall.
Well, the Flyers' lead didn't last very long, and you know, in Montreal, we mentioned before Game 5 that the Flyers coaching staff had tried to play down the aspect of having a lead. But as you look at this goal that tied the game, the one credited to Bobby Smith, Jeff Chychrun put it in. I'll tell you what, the Flyers that I spoke to today said it was so much easier to play with the lead. You can beat the puck to death, allow it to do the work. There is Ed Snyder with his wife Martha to the side. Ed Snyder, a grandfather for the second time today. There is Jay Snyder, the president of the Flyers. His wife Terry gave birth to an 8-pound, 3-ounce baby boy named Saul today. Congratulations to them.
Puck tipped on back, and it is Ganey trying to get loose, then back to Svoboda. Dumps it right back along. Carboneau centered, and Hextall got a piece of that. There'll be a penalty coming up, and it'll be against the Flyers. High sticking is the call, and it'll be Samuelson who will sit out the 2 minutes for Philadelphia.
You can imagine that there's a combination of English and Swedish being spoken in the penalty box right now. Kind of comical when you're around Kjell Samuelson and he gets angry because he goes back and forth between English and Swedish. But it's not real comical for him right now. He just took his man out in front. Don Kuharski whistles him off. And I'm sure one of the things that makes Kjell Samuelson or is making him angry right now is that he got leveled by Bobby Smith. There was a hit from behind that even looked like a charge earlier in the game that wasn't called. And for something like that, he goes. So players try to get a gauge on the standards that a referee is setting, and when they seem inconsistent, it's frustrating.
Chris Chelios keeps, hands back over to Smith. Then to Chelios, a drive, deflected in front, and Hextall with a save as Keane got a piece of that one as it was steaming toward his net.
Mike Keane has found himself in a Montreal uniform. A couple of years ago, nobody even knew Mike Keane existed except Serge Savard, general manager of the Montreal Canadiens. And now not only is he in uniform, but he plays right side with Bobby Smith and Mats Naslund.
Chelios flips, Hextall wobbles it along, and Poulin able to clear back to where you watch Chelios play it. 20 seconds gone on the Canadiens power play. They're one for the previous attempt that they have. This is their second of the night. The Flyers have had two as well, but have come up empty for the night and the series. Poulin with a pass across that is cut off by Svoboda. Takes some real bona fide lumber from Brian Propp. Svoboda hands back over to Chris Chelios in the final 2.5 of this period. Chelios bangs it around the boards, and Hextall able to stop it. Hextall hooks one, flipped it off the stick of Smith, back to Keane. Tries to get loose for a toss to the net, and then worked one to Chelios, but the whole play faltered as it had been broken down. Now Svoboda across to Mats Naslund, who skates for some control here. 9 shots apiece, 1 goal apiece, down to the last 2 minutes of the period as it is bumped back in deep. Now Hextall controls, hands over to Gord Murphy. And it is the Flyers who were a little flustered back in their own end of the ice this time. 45 seconds to go on the power play. Shift change on. Derek Smith comes out. Eklund does as well. Chychrun and Kartner in back. Right back along comes Peter Svoboda. Svoboda with a pass in front, directed wide. Around it comes, and it is Chelios. Turns it back across, and Eklund tries to play, and Kartner knocks it back out. Now it is Richie shoveling it on to Svoboda. Along it comes to Chelios, and he was hit hard by Kartner. Good hit on Richie by Derek Smith. And then it is Eklund. So the Flyers resume their physical game. Puck driven right back down and set up by Roy as we're down to the last 5 seconds on the power play. A pass ahead by Robinson. Derek Smith skates it down. Out of the box comes Samuelson, and it's wheeled back to Robinson again. Then on to Shane Corson, leading scorer for the series. Lemieux a shot, and that blocked away by Hextall's stick. Then Lemieux chased off by Howe. Puck dumped along now to Derek Smith. Tried to work for where he thought Sutter was, but it was Lemieux instead. And Samuelson playing in the last 45 seconds of this period. Along with Bill Clement, Mike Emmerich from the Spectrum in Philadelphia, the game is tied, 1 goal apiece. The series is Montreal 3-2. 4 games means the winner takes on Calgary in the Stanley Cup Finals. It is Howe flipping by the breaking Sutter over to Robinson into the glove of McPhee. And McPhee took a shoulder from Mellenby, but not until he dropped it off to Skrudland, who connects back ahead with Lemieux. Stepped into by Sutter. It's punched ahead by Desjardins. Howe wraps it around. 13 seconds to go. Puck kept by Robinson and swept for the slot. But right there to clear it along was Propp. Given up to Lemieux, then flung out by Howe, and a chance for Mellenby up the wing. 3 seconds to go. Two. A shot. A stick save by Roy. And the horn sounds to end a thrilling first period here from the Spectrum.
Hockey, it's more than a game. For some, it's their faith, their commitment. Less than a religion, but not by much. Refined throughout history, but unchanged in its enduring simplicity. Played by a group of men whose hearts pump life beneath a crest for which they would sacrifice body and soul. It is a ferocious ballet of speed and skill, force and bravery. Beautifully captured in all its splendor on NHL DVDs from Warner Home Entertainment. The history. The legends. The moments. The glory. Own it today.
Every Stanley Cup final has thrilling moments, but perhaps none more memorable than a Game 7 for the right to hoist Lord Stanley.
The waiting is over!
Now, with the Game 7 Collection DVD box set, you can relive these unforgettable contests.
And after 22 years, Raymond Moore!
Hosted by Craig Simpson. Available wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
Hockey Fights Cancer has raised more than $9 million for cancer care, research, and awareness.
Don't give up.
Join our hockey family in the fight against cancer. Log on to NHL.com and join the fight.
Don't give up.
Just noting Rule 55B, anytime a goal is scored when a player from the defending side causes it to go in, there shouldn't be any assists, so there may be a change there. Mike Keane has, well, they've changed it now. Out of that replay, apparently they've determined that Mike Keane, as well as Jeff Chychrun, got a piece of that. And so Keane has been given the goal. Smith and Naslund have been credited with the assist. I was anticipating if there was any change at all, it might be that Bobby Smith would just have the goal all alone with no assist for the rule that I cited. But regardless of all of that folderol, we're underway here in the second period. 25 seconds gone, and Scott Mellenby trying to work ahead but being denied by Corson. It is Corson going back and checked by Mellenby. Puck tipped along by Brian Propp. Corson tried to force it further, and the puck taken behind by Rick Green. Here's Green dumping one along for Gainey. Bob Gainey sets it up for Green. Nearly run to the ditch by Sutter, but meanwhile the puck taken and thrown back by Kartner. Then back across, Gainey wanted to play, but it was Samuelson denying him. Now it is Howe banking one off of Brian Propp. It's swatted further by Sutter. Flyers make a change. Tockett and Bullard step out. Long pass ahead is forced back down. And it is Hextall to take. Howe and Samuelson comprise the defense for the Flyers in this 1-1 tie. 1 minute and 15 seconds into the second period of play. Rick Tockett is out now. Tockett able to pick this one up and swing it over for Eklund. Chopped out of the air by Chelios. Tockett forced one that went off Mike Bullard. It is Eklund trying to get away from Skrudland and tripped up. Eklund slow to get up, seems to be okay, is back up with it. 4-on-2 Montreal. Up the wing it comes to Skrudland, he couldn't control. Centered one, a backhander knocked down by Hextall. Good save by Hextall, and a 2-on-2 back for the Flyers. Moving on in as Pelle Eklund has Tockett ready with the gun loaded, but Eklund keeps in to Tockett, and his one-time attempt with the puck floating out of the air failed.
You know, this kind of wide open play is the kind of play that Pat Burns really doesn't want. He really chastised his guys after game 5, and he said, we can't let the Flyers dictate how this game is played. And to a degree, the Flyers have been able to do that tonight. That's obviously to a Flyers advantage. Montreal likes to grind her to a halt.
Chris Chelios is there for Montreal with a pass that came right over to Ilkka Sinisalo, and he starts back in. A pass over to Smith. Lost, but right near Poulin. Poulin moves in and crunches with Naslund. The puck to Sinisalo, floated to the front, and Chelios just able to fidget away from Derek Smith. It is Naslund ahead, moving along with Claude Lemieux. Dumps it for Smith, and we get a whistle, stoppage of play. And Ron Finn is pointing, and it could be for too many men on the ice.
So Montreal has in fact been handed a penalty that Bobby Smith will serve. Too many men on the ice.
First time the Canadiens have had a bench minor penalty for too many men in the playoffs.
Well, maybe this will be the break for the Flyers. After the break that Montreal got on their goal, you know that a disciplined hockey team, I'm not surprised at that number that you just gave us, that it's the first one in the playoffs because they play such a disciplined style. They have disciplined athletes, but you'll take it, boy, if they get one.
Puck driven around by Howe, slowed by Roy. Kerr checked along the boards by Rick Green. Two-a-side battle, and Eklund comes in. Kerr trying to muscle it along. A stick comes loose. Can't really tell who the owner of it is. Now I guess it's Rick Green. He's without one. Puck floated along, and Eklund goes back. Centered one off of Green, and he handed it away. And it is Brian Propp there. A Flyer touch, so no hand pass. Puck picked up now by Kerr. Feeds one to Howe. Gives to Murphy. Fires, and it went wide. Off that loose stick. Puck fed off a chink in the boards and drilled back down. And right now, there are an awful lot of strange things happening out here in the way that puck is traveling. Here is Gord Murphy. Power play time to the Flyers is down to a minute five. 16 and a half to go in the second period. Kelly Eklund creeps ahead, hands it back off to Murphy. Murphy steps along, feeds it back to Eklund, who creeps in. Shovels off to Howe. Wrist shot deflected wide as getting a piece of it was Propp. Then to Kerr. Over to Eklund. Set up for Murphy. Drive, and that knocked down by Carboneau. And Carboneau can start back out for the Canadiens along with McPhee and Ludwig. Pass went off McPhee. Back to get it with Gord Murphy. In comes Mike Bullard and is able to force it away to Howe. Penalty time down now to 30 seconds. It is Kerr sending one along, and Brian Propp trying to get to it. Couldn't center as a strong defensive play made that time by Craig Ludwig. And McPhee jabs it on the backhand, lifting it down the ice.
Mike Bullard was all alone in front, but you're right, Mike. You never know what Craig Ludwig is going to do when he is defending. That time, he gave Brian Propp some space under his stick until Propp was ready to pass, and then just lowered the boom on him.
Offside is called against the Flyers in the final 8 seconds of their power play.
For 40 years, the Pittsburgh Penguins have provided some of the NHL's most unforgettable moments. And now you can relive them with the Penguins' 10 Greatest Games box set, as voted on by the fans.
This moves in towards the goaltender, shoots, and he scores!
Hosted by Mike Lang, the original broadcasts capture all the amazing action.
Oh, you'd have to be here to believe it!
Available wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
In this jersey, I pledge to wreak havoc on my opponent's plus-minus.
To make one-timers happen way more than once.
I pledge that my team will scrap for every single point on the schedule.
In this jersey, I pledge the holes are only holes if they're open.
Shop.nhl.com presents the RBK Edge jersey. All 30 teams reinvented for more strength, more speed, more belief.
In this jersey, I pledge to play for the logo on the front, not the name on the back.
What do you pledge? Visit shop.nhl.com for your jersey.
Hi, this is Tim McGraw. Today and every day is the right time to support the American Red Cross, who gives disaster assistance to people when they need it most. You can help the victims of thousands of disasters across the country each year by making a financial gift to the American Red Cross Disaster Relief Fund, which enables the Red Cross to provide shelter, food, counseling, and other assistance to those in need. Please call 1-800-HELP now. Together, we can save a life.
Watch Ovechkin fly like Bure. See Phaneuf smash like Stevens.
Malkin! Sensational!
In a new generation of NHL stars, there are remnants of the past. The Just Like Me DVD shows how a new group of heroes is influenced by hockey's greatest generation.
You want to talk about good young talent?
Available January 22nd wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
Oh my goodness!
Short-handed for the Flyers, Howe and Samuelson with Poulin up front along with Brian Propp. Puck rolled along and Patrick Roy stops, Chelios takes it, has Naslin moving in stride, along with Bobby Smith. Svoboda also out with Mike Keane. Here is Naslin able to scoot by. Mats Naslin takes a look, has Keane in front, gives to the back to Chelios. Then Chelios back over for a drive by Naslin, and that one went wide. Puck fed back along and taken by Chris Chelios. Chelios across to Naslin. Prop watching him. Chelios hammers one. He scores! It may be Smith on the deflection, or maybe Chelios all the way, but the Canadiens have gotten a power play goal and are ahead 2-1.
And it wasn't anything really very fancy. Naslin lays this back for Chelios, but check the action in front of Ron Hextall. And Bobby Smith did, in fact, get a piece of it. But all Montreal was trying to do was spring Chris Chelios loose back on the blue line for a shot, hope to screen Ron Hextall. And it wasn't a screen, it was something even better for Montreal. It was a deflection. Samuelson was trying to move Smith. Keane was over to the side. Montreal scores a power play goal, and they lead 2-1.
Ludwig gets the other assist. It only took the Canadiens 38 seconds on that power play to get their second power play goal of the night in three opportunities. 12 minutes left in the second. Rick Tocchet moves in for the Flyers. Turns one across the goal mouth wide. Back to Chychrun, and that one sticked away by Roy. Lemieux shoulders with Terry Kartner. Kartner tried to move in, hooked it across to Eklund, then Fuller to drive. Trickled right behind Roy and was picked up behind him by Chelios. They can't get it out. Kartner able to keep it in for the Flyers. Steps away from one, feeds to Chychrun. Drive, and that one knocked down by Ludwig. Chychrun works a pass that bounces to Tocchet, yanked it in front, and Chelios there. And the Canadiens cleared it off a Flyer player at the bench. Wow.
Boy, the Flyers did exactly what they had to do. Come right back, take it to Montreal, show them that they're right in the game and that they're going to try and close the gap right away, and a couple of great scoring chances. They just couldn't get it through. Terry Kartner kept the play alive a couple of times. Mike Bullard on this blast, what did that hit? It hit something. Chris Chelios was able to get it out of the way. Patrick Roy, I think he might think at this time, at this stage, that he has it under him. After that, Chychrun's big blast was blocked by Ludwig. All kinds of pressure, but no results.
You see the number 12 of Tim Kerr for Philadelphia. Flyers will use Acton at center and Secord on the left. Howe and Samuelson the defense. And the puck comes back to Shel Samuelson, then across to Howe. Howe flips one back in. Roy watches as it's tapped away to the corner. Ryan Walter there, rammed by Acton. Carboneau tried to lift it out, and it came across to Green. Then dumped along by Courtnall and brought out by Carboneau. Pass went off the big skate of Shel Samuelson, and it's Howe turning it back. His pass is off Secord. Acton chopped it back deeper, and the Canadiens have to turn and go. It is Roy, sealed up by Kerr, but the puck comes back across to Walter, so no opportunity for the Flyers to take advantage of Roy's leaving the goal. Now it is Acton connecting back across with Mark Howe. Howe to Kerr, too far for Acton. Acton goes in, boom to the boards by Green. Puck turned along and brought back up by Carboneau. Moves back out with Courtnall and Walter. Carboneau, big drive, blocked away by Jay Wells. Puck behind and gathered in by Gord Murphy. The rookie defenseman leads the rush back out with a pass that went behind the breaking Flyers. And so back ahead come the Canadiens again, and Corson was in early. Now it's Poulin, but that one knocked down by Courtnall. Up with it is Sinisalo. Off his stick, backhand though, thrown back in by Secord. Roy sets and Larry Robinson starts away. Hands back on to Corson, then back up to Richie. Stefan Richie trying to get through, checked off by both Jay Wells and Gord Murphy. Derek Smith spins it back down, and Larry Robinson will go to get it. Halfway through the period, both teams with two shots, 12 in the game. Richie moves in, couldn't get the shot away as Jay Wells defended, and then Smith crunched into him. Meanwhile, the puck dumped along and Hextall out to get it. Swings it along, and it is Desjardins able to hold. Bounces one further, it's chopped along, but off of Dave Poulin. It's Richie scooping it on back to Desjardins. It may seem as though the Canadiens are attacking and organizing, like they're on the power play, but they are not right now.
Four paws and one big shaggy heart. Doesn't he deserve to be covered too? Introducing pet injury coverage from Progressive. Now when Progressive covers your car, we cover your pet at no extra charge. Now that's Progressive. Go to progressive.com or call a local independent agent.
8 minutes into the second period, and the Detroit Red Wings lead the Montreal Canadiens 3-2.
The game has changed. So should the way you watch it.
A great day of hockey.
NHL Network, the home of hockey. Available in HD.
Is this the year the Cup comes to Buffalo?
To Carolina?
To Pittsburgh?
Is this the year someone scores 50 and 38?
In 37?
In 36? Is this the year someone scores 200 points?
Is this the year kids start taping their sticks like Stahl?
Is this the year someone scores 93?
Is this the year a forward becomes unstoppable?
Is this the year a goalie stops everything?
Is this the year we finally figure out who's dad's favorite?
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
Этот год?
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
Everybody has arrived here, and you can see that it's just a tug of war in tight. That's Gord Murphy, the white helmet on the left. He had come in to help his partner Jay Wells, and over this season, you know, these two guys have grown real close. Gord Murphy and Jay Wells, they've been paired just about since the beginning. And when one gets into a scrape, the other one comes right in. Jeff Chychrun there, number six, pushing away at Stefan Richer with Craig Ludwig hanging all over him. So Wells with a double minor, Corson just with two. That puts the Flyers in another jam, and the way Montreal's power play has been tonight, 2-for-2, you got to know that the Flyers are going to try and keep their penalties down now. They have to. I'm wondering if Jay Wells was shaken up in the deal, because the penalty box door is open. Nobody is there. Jay Wells left the ice and went up the runway to the Flyers' room.
Fan recalling allegations made about Koharski last year at about this time.
Guy's a marketing genius.
Well, Montreal goes on power play number four. The Flyers have only won one game in which they have had fewer power play goals than the opposition, and that was game five of the Washington series, the same night that many of you remember Ron Hextall scored a shorthanded goal. Chelios flips and right to Brian Propp, wanted to start it ahead, this Svoboda. Montreal leading in the game 2-1. Svoboda taken to the wall by Samuelson. Pivoting in is Mike Keane. Tried to shake one in front. It went off the leg of Howe. They keep it alive on the power play. Back to Svoboda. Then over to Naslund. Svoboda once more. Fires one. Oh, and it was tipped by Hextall and trickled wide. Keane able to jab it back along to Naslund. That's Naslund controlling. Keane at the front. Takes a jab from Hextall as the drive comes through from Svoboda. Ryan Propp went crunching into Chelios. Puck taken by Chelios and hurried to anyone in particular, and it's lifted back out by Howe. Here is Naslund starting ahead. Gets Cortnall on the break. Drive is into Hextall, and he hangs on. We get a stoppage of play. He was ready to put it back into play, but Koharski comes by, and just with that little tap to Hextall, more or less concedes that he anticipated a freeze and decided to blow the whistle.
Here's Mike Keane to the side of the net looking for a rebound. Now, he is not in position to screen. He was trying for a deflection or for a rebound, but it never even got to him. It deflected right through him. Here's the last shot that Don Kuharski ended up blowing down. See how far to the net Kortnall is? Or at least Hextall is. He knew that Kortnall wasn't going to cut in on him because Terry Karkner was there.
Clank, clank, he's back to work again. Carboneau to take the draw from Ron Sutter. Walter on the left, Kortnall on the right. Slavo to the left point and the right point, Chelios. Off the tie-up, the puck comes back to Chris Chelios. Hands back over to Svoboda. Chelios again. Waits, fires, knocked down by Poulin, and he clears it back out. 42 seconds to go on the power play to the Canadiens.
You know, it's pretty important for the Flyers forwards that are at the top of the box to get a piece of that big shot that Chelios has from the point, because there are big battles going on in front. Montreal has still got two guys in front tying up two Flyer defensemen.
Chelios, a shot answered by Hextall. Brought back up ice by Dave Poulin. Cruising along with Propp, shovels it off for him. And Propp checked to the corner with Svoboda. Meanwhile, the puck taken by Walter, nudged ahead by Chelios for Kortnall. And it is Russ Kortnall dropping one in, but Hextall out to get it. Hextall sends it, and it went right through Walter as we're down to the last 3 seconds, 2 seconds of the power play. Out of the box, Kerr. Robinson works a pass for Kortnall. And back it squirts near Chychrun. Hextall out, slugs it ahead. We're going to get a penalty coming up against Montreal. Ahead it's brought by Brian Propp. Hextall to the bench, but just as he arrives, the Canadiens touch, a slashing call is coming up.
29 plus 51. First thing I'm going to do is take the nine. Plus one, we have eight. Hockey gives a kid confidence, self-esteem, and mighty good reflexes, too. Learn how to get started at onegoal.com, a website sponsored by hockey's leadership companies.
Every Stanley Cup final has thrilling moments, but perhaps none more memorable than a Game 7 for the right to hoist Lord Stanley.
The waiting is over!
Now, with the Game 7 Collection DVD box set, you can relive these unforgettable contests.
And after 22 years, Raymond Bork!
Hosted by Craig Simpson. Available wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
Hockey Fights Cancer has raised more than $9 million for cancer care, research, and awareness.
Don't give up.
Join our hockey family in the fight against cancer. Log on to NHL.com and join the fight.
Don't give up.
For 40 years, the Pittsburgh Penguins have provided some of the NHL's most unforgettable moments. And now you can relive them with the Penguins' 10 Greatest Games box set, as voted on by the fans.
This moves in towards the goaltender, shoots, he scores!
Hosted by Mike Lang, the original broadcasts capture all the amazing action.
Oh, you'd have to be here to believe it!
Available wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
Russ Kortnall is off. He never made contact with a Flyer with a stick, but he swung around in frustration. It was kind of one of those air slashes. Right at the bottom of your screen. See him swing around with the stick on Dave Poole, and that's a flashback to his Toronto days. That's not a Pat Burns type play at all. In a game where you're leading 2-1, that's a breakdown, a discipline breakdown.
Ludwig hammers this one back down. So strong that Hextall couldn't stop it. Gord Murphy crunched by Skrudland. Puck skips back off Bullard, brought ahead by Mark Howe. Moves it in and hands to Kerr. Kerr across to Bullard, and he couldn't take the pass. Punch back along the boards. Tockett tries to get it. It's worked back for Murphy, but he couldn't gather. And back down it'll come to Hextall. 30 seconds gone on the Flyers' power play. They are 0 for the prior three and 0 for the series. Tockett steps ahead. Watched by Carboneau. Tockett tries to get by Green, who says no. Loose puck, Kerr going for it behind, able to control. Tim Kerr slides it back over to Tockett. Then back to Murphy, to Tocchet once more. Then Murphy, a shot! Oh, and a tip at the front by Kerr. And then the puck is frozen and the net has been dislodged, and the referee, Don Koharski, says no, it was not a Canadian who did it.
This one's touch and go. Rick Green was pushed toward the net. But from here, it sure looked like, even though he was pushed, he decided at the last minute, boy, I'm headed this way, I'm going to knock it off. Mike Bullard gives him a shot. But then, see, yeah, no question about it. Rick Green was, he had his balance. He could have pulled out, but he didn't. He kept his momentum going and then said, boy, I'm here, I might as well knock it off. That's not the way Don Koharski saw it. But you could tell from that replay that Rick Green really went for it. One more look at it. Now, that doesn't look like a guy that's just been hit into the net, does it?
No. Flyers lose territory out of this, too, because there'll be a neutral zone faceoff. Net dislodged and the blame laid on a Flyers player, and so neutralized faceoff with still a minute 5 to go on this power play. 6:05 to go in the second. Canadians ahead in the game 2-1. Keane and Smith have power play goals for Montreal. Scott Mellenby opened the scoring for the Flyers. Puck thrown along and Roy is there. Roy able to tap one that came to Carboneau, crunched by Murphy. Then directed back to Carkner. Carkner took a swat, then worked it over to Kerr, and a good stiff shot was blocked off by Roy. Now it is Murphy. Murphy laying it over to Eklund. Kerr at the front, so is Brian Propp. Propp has room, so Eklund passes to him. Propp will work the outside back to Murphy. Murphy still with it to Propp, a one-timer, and that blocked away by Craig Ludwig. Propp tries to yank it through and does. Here's Eklund walking behind, shoved down by Ludwig, and the puck came to Chelios, who cleared it back down the ice. 15 seconds to go on the power play as Hextall nearly at the blue line to direct to Murphy. Then Eklund and Howe. 5:10 to go in the second. Moving ahead with it now is Howe. Takes a look toward Propp, has Eklund behind. Howe turns behind the net. Penalty time is up. Howe, a wrist shot knocked down by Ludwig and cleared away by Carboneau. Brought back up ice by Bob Gainey. It's a 3-on-2. Here's Gainey moving in. The trailer is Chelios. He gives to him. Score! Chris Chelios converts a 3-on-2. And the Canadians, just after they'd gone back to full strength, have a 3-to-1 lead.
You know, Gordon Murphy did everything he could to try and block this. And you know, Bob Gainey actually had a guy open in front that he could have passed to. But that shot may have been partially screened by Gordon Murphy. We'll see another angle. Reverse angle, Chelios has it, and he got rid of it pretty quickly. I think that one just caught Ron Hextall between the legs. You know that, the five hole. There haven't been many go through Ron Hextall's legs in this series. But Chris Chelios snapped that one, and Montreal has a 3-to-1 lead. And you know, if you've watched this series, that's a pretty sizable lead, the way Montreal can clamp it down.
Hextall off Samuelson for Tocchet, but to Svoboda. In the final 4.5 of the second period, Richie nudges it along to Corson, eyed up by Al Secord. Corson with a pass to Svoboda, had a man in front, Gainey, but it was cut off by Samuelson and worked back up to Ron Sutter, who steps ahead. Sutter lost, though, to Rick Green, and Green shovels it back out. Flyers in the midst of a change, and the Canadians are really upset, thinking the Flyers had too many men on the ice. Pat Burns just railing at the bench. Puck sent back along by Poulin. Around to get it is Green. Tocchet is there. Corson is there, too. Puck dumped back to Svoboda. Gets away from the check of Derek Smith. It is forced off for Tocchet. Tocchet tried to center but couldn't. Svoboda, while prone, worked it along, and it is cut off by Corson. Corson lobs one for Naslund, but got the linesman Gerard Gauthier instead. Now it is Green, directed across, and Mellenby couldn't take it. Mats Naslund able to flip one back in. Jay Wells cuts it off for the Flyers with a pass ahead to Poulin. Can't get it away from Bobby Smith. Now it is Wells again forcing it back deep. Patrick Roy steers it back off, and ahead with it is Robinson. working up the wing, and ahead with it is Keane. He's got Bobby Smith with him, and the shot is knocked down, and then Smith carried hard to the boards by Murphy. It is Mellenby trying to control and bring it back up ice along to Dave Poulin, and Poulin fires it back around. Mellenby is there first. Can't step by the defensive work of Desjardins. Then back ahead to Smith, who's sealed up by Karkner. Bullard turned it across his own goal mouth wide. It is Naslund flipping one, and Karkner is back. Boy, you can see the screws being turned by these Canadians again. Puck flipped, and McPhee cut it off and fired a shot that went wide. It is Jeff Chychrun paddling one out to Mellenby, scoops it on now to Eklund. Eklund moving along with Bullard, drops to him. Bullard is shot, knocked down by Ludwig. Craig Ludwig with three solid defensive plays such as that one in this period. Back ahead, it's brought by McPhee. Tries to get by Kerr. Down he goes, and the puck fed around by Hextall. Chelios hammered to the boards and glass by Karkner. In comes Mike Bullard. Little backhand pass is on the money to Eklund, but he's tied up by Chelios checking. Has to pull away in the final 2:05 of this period, a period in which the Flyers have gotten four shots and the Canadians have gotten six. Offside is called. A small number on the opposition side in a Montreal game is not odd. The Flyers with only one goal tonight. Here is Courtnall moving ahead, and Howe watching him. Courtnall and Howe contest for it, and Howe able to swing back out to Tockett. Tockett watched by Green, and the puck just dropped back off. In 11 of the last 22 years, that's since the Flyers came into the league, Montreal has had the lowest goals against average, half of those years, and this year was one of them. Here is Ron Sutter, flips it up the wing, too far for Brian Propp. Propp taken to the boards by Rick Green. Flurry of activity, and Tockett emerges, dropping it back now to Sutter. But it is Walter starting it back up ice. Pass came right onto the stick of Gord Murphy. A minute and 15 seconds to go in the second period. Back to take it is Svoboda. Hammered to the boards by the shoulder of Ron Sutter. Green taken off by Propp. Sutter comes back for more on Svoboda. But it is Carboneau bringing it back up ice and handing back on to Courtnall. Courtnall drops. Bob Gainey steps to it. Punches it away from Wells. Mellenby to watch Gainey. Shift change on for Montreal. And so Gainey had to be careful about making a pass to Flyers. Puck turned around for Robinson, slides it back for Hextall to tap for Murphy. Final 38 seconds of play in this second period. Poulin sees that one deflect up to Mellenby, who chops it in on goal, and it is held by Patrick Roy with 31 seconds left in the period.
Intervention is a great time to pick up that copy of the next edition of Flyer Magazine. Make yourself eligible for lucky number drawing.
The showcase stores are holding Flyer Fan Appreciation Days for now through May the 21st. All Flyers merchandise is 25% off, so visit a Delaware Valley showcase store soon.
Well, the challenge now for the Flyers is to stay disciplined. They can't afford any more penalties. They actually have to draw some. They've got to keep the legs churning. They have to try and stick to a game plan that I know was going to be tight anyway. But now with Captain Bob Gainey leading the way, Larry Robinson out on the ice, the Montreal Canadiens are going to be very tight. The Flyers, for the time being, still have to be patient. They can't gamble. They can't end up with a 4-1 deficit. They got to close the gap. Patience is the watchword for the Flyers, and hard work now, at least for the time being, into the third period.
Chychrun shot knocked down by Walter. Up with it comes Gainey, and he just makes the Flyers chase again. This one will be short of icing, and so Karkner takes it. Gainey couldn't have time to better pass down the ice. Puck worked back ahead now to Tim Kerr. Blocked over by Walter. Karkner starts it up the wing, and Al Secord is there. Secord pivots. Little pass picked off by Bullard. The slot to Karkner. A shot is blocked away. They had Kerr at the side of the net. And the Canadians again blocked a Flyer passing play or shooting play. Shut it off, and so the period ends with the Canadiens still holding a two-goal lead.
In this jersey, I pledge to wreak havoc on my opponent's plus-minus.
To make one-timers happen way more than once.
I pledge that my team will scrap for every single point on the schedule.
In this jersey, I pledge the holes are only holes if they're open.
Shop.nhl.com presents the RBK Edge jersey. All 30 teams reinvented for more strength, more speed, more belief.
In this jersey, I pledge to play for the logo on the front, not the name on the back.
What do you pledge?
Visit shop.nhl.com for your jersey.
Watch Ovechkin fly like Bure. See Finneau smash like Stevens.
Malkin, sensational!
In a new generation of NHL stars, there are remnants of the past. The Just Like Me DVD shows how a new group of heroes is influenced by hockey's greatest generation.
You want to talk about good young talent?
Available January 22nd wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
Oh my goodness!
8 minutes into the second period, and the Detroit Red Wings lead the Montreal Canadiens 3-2.
The game has changed. So should the way you watch it.
A great day of hockey.
NHL Network, the home of hockey. Available in HD.
Is this the year the Cup comes to Buffalo?
To Carolina?
To Pittsburgh?
Is this the year someone scores 50 and 38?
In 37?
In 36? Is this the year someone scores 200 points?
Is this the year kids start taping their sticks like Stahl?
Is this the year someone scores 93?
Is this the year a forward becomes unstoppable?
Is this the year a goalie stops everything?
Is this the year we finally figure out who's dad's favorite?
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
Этот год?
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
The ovation from their fans as they came back out onto the ice to start this third period of play. Ron Sutter jams it back, and Jeff Chychrun will go to get it. Chychrun and Karkner, the defense. Ron Sutter with Brian Propp on the left and Scott Mellenby on the right. Chychrun bringing it back up. Mike Keane along with Corson and Gainey. Three strong defensive-minded players from Montreal. I guess you'd have to include almost all the players on this team if you're describing defensive-minded, as that shot screamed wide from Keane. It is Chychrun nudging it along, and Ron Sutter goes barreling in. Chychrun hooks it back along, and Brian Propp is there. Turns it loose back over to Terry Karkner. Karkner back up the wing to Ron Sutter. Angles one, but Mellenby was turned toward the other corner. Puck dumped right back along and controlled now by Chelios. It is brought back up by Bob Gainey. Watched by Samuelson, and Samuelson blocked that shot. Gainey tried to follow through, getting it to Lemieux, and Lemieux, not really a factor in this series, has just one assist in 5 2/3 games. Ekstahl tends, Howe shakes it back along for Eklund. Eklund's pass too far for the breaking Mike Bullard. Bullard goes right back after it and seals up with Ludwig, then tries to center one, and that knocked away. Rick Tocchet goes for it, and the puck trapped by Chris Chelios, and we get a halt to play.
You know, ever since game one, when Chris Chelios took Brian Propp out, we said that in game one he would have a big X on him. He would be a marked man. Well, the Flyers have had a tough time zeroing in on that X. You know, after the game, a lot of people that follow the Montreal Canadiens regularly said Chris Chelios isn't going to change the way he played just because a lot of the Flyers are going to be out to get him. You know what? He hasn't.
No, he can dance out of the way pretty well,
yeah,
too, and
does.
Get a good pass away.
You bet. He's got great peripheral vision, and he's quick on his feet.
Mike Bullard on the tie-up with Carboneau. Canadians able to shovel it along. Svoboda connects with Courtnall. Then back it comes to Green. Rushed by Pelle Eklund. And then it's turned back over to Courtnall, who just drops it back out. At what point, if the score stays the same, do you think the Flyers will have to start taking chances?
They've got it by the halfway point in this period.
Okay. Howe with a pass, knocked down by Courtnall. They try to work it ahead. Samuelson ties up with Ryan Walter. Now it is Bullard scooping it ahead, and Tocchet shovels it back around. Eklund goes to get it. Chased off by Walter, and so the puck went by them all and is taken by Murphy.
And you know, the sign that will tell us that the Flyers are taking some chances and trying to open it up will be possibly giving up two-on-ones and three-on-twos going the other way.
All right, we'll watch for that too as we've completed 2 minutes and 5 seconds of this period. Here's Eklund centering one off of skates. They poke away at it, and it's squibbed wide. Bullard and Tocchet were jamming but could not get one in on Roy. A drive by Murphy in front, and Tocchet shot went high off of Green, and then he got another one away that was sent wide. And it is Naslund flipping it back out.
I'm not sure Rick Tocchet got all of that first one. Rick Green was down to block it anyway, but Rick Tocchet had it all parked, loaded, ready to go, And I'm not sure that he really nailed it the way he wanted to.
Robinson chased off by Derek Smith. And then Smith came back that time at Bobby Smith. Got a good hit on him, but the Canadians cleared it back to Murphy anyway. Murphy trying to pivot away from Keane and went down. Now it is Wells, Poulin, Sinisalo. Sinisalo once more, shouldered by Robinson. Bobby Smith sees Derek Smith knock it behind. Puck picked up and threaded back along, but there to get it is Karkner. Then to Poulin, who centered one, and a backhander by Sinisalo went off a leg. And it is Naslund spinning it back down. Flyers jammed the net pretty well.
The Flyers weren't given credit for a shot on goal. I guess maybe even that Tocchet backhander was headed for the side of the net. But that tells you how Montreal clamps it down, but Sinisalo has just hit something.
Chychrun, a drive, deflected, it went wide, is getting a piece of it was Acton. Tries to center for Kerr and can't. Walter and Acton tie up. Flyers are getting some chances here, but not getting them on the goal. Good deflection set up, but it was tipped wide. Now it is rolled back down, and Terry Karkner takes the little tap from Hextall. Karkner takes a look, has a pass ahead now to Kerr. Dropped right back by Ludwig. Karkner able to weave away from one. But this taken over by Stefan Richer. Richer trying to move by Samuelson, just blocks it away casually and is rolled back out to Al Secord. Jammed back to the Canadiens line, though, by Gainey. Chelios flips off of Mark Howe. Richer steps to it, and he poked it back deep. Richer with a goal and three assists in this series thus far. Puck dropped on back, and it is Rick Green to get it. Green gives it back to Svoboda, who tries to get in. Samuelson watching, so Sutter comes by. Mark Howe connects on to Propp. Propp has to regather and give back to Howe. The four checkers are Skrudland along with Mike McPhee. Lemieux out on that line as well. Skrudland locked up with Howe, and they went in early. A delayed offside will be wiped now as the Flyers clear the zone and the Canadians bring it out. Svoboda pestered by Brian Propp's checking. Has to hand it back to Rick Green, then Peter Svoboda once more. On to McPhee. McPhee just chops one along, and Samuelson strides for that. On the turning stick of Brian Propp. 15 minutes to go now in the third period. The score has been 3-1 since 4:50 remained in the second. Flyers scored first, Scott Mellenby, midway in the first period. 3 minutes later, answered by Keane on a power play goal. Then Smith and Chelios in the second period got goals. Smith on the power play, too. Mellenby spun one, but Murphy had not yet arrived. Flyers must control and neutralize and hand it back over to Pelle Eklund. Shoveled for Mellenby, but that went back down. This is Peter Svoboda. Watched by Bullard. Svoboda checked off. Puck taken by Eklund. Then to Bullard, and he tried to work it to the front. Carboneau knocked it away. Loose puck, and there'll be a penalty coming up.
Paul Coffey going for the net. In too deep to shoot. Now he tries to center and score.
Puck is loose to center. Coffey and Smith, 2-on-1. Coffey, 7-2-1.
He missed Hunter. Coffey following up. The slap shot scores! 39th goal of the year for Coffey. It's against Bodger, turns away. Here's Coffey coming up on the play. Here's Coffey going right in. Scores! Jockey is there, rolls it back behind the net, intercepted by Suominen. Suominen checked by Schneps. Curry rolls it to Gretzky. Gretzky out in front, sets up. Coffey, who scores! Curry now has a 9-game point streak. Paul Coffey assisting at 19-20. And Coffey scores!
He is some hockey player.
36 years old, although some question that. Here's Coffey on a rush, right in, shoot, scores!
It's something I can't really, really celebrate right now because we've got a lot of hockey ahead of us. I mean, we've got to win the Stanley Cup, and it's something that I'll sit back. I mean, it's when I leave the room here, I'll really be happy in the summertime. And it's like winning two Stanley Cups. Years down the road, you cherish stuff like that.
We'll be right back.
In a new generation of NHL stars, there are remnants of the past. The Just Like Me DVD shows how a new group of heroes is influenced by hockey's greatest generation. Available January 22nd wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
Canadiens to go on power play number 5. They're 2 for the prior 4. And Chris Chelios will move it back up now for Montreal. Lifts one. Naslund wants to get to it, but it came around to Hextall, and Samuelson really boomed Naslund to the boards and glass. Now it is Keane taking a look at the slot. Nothing there but white and orange jerseys. Puck turned back now to Bobby Smith. Keane at the front. Got it to Keane. Another shot and another shot. Boy, it looked like Keane had no chance at all to even take a pass, let alone get a shot away, but he had at least 2 and maybe a third.
You see what happens sometime when you try to play a stick on a guy instead of actually just trying to move his body out of the way. Brian Propp took a little swat at him, but then moved back, and, you know, Mark Howe didn't know that Brian Propp had left. See at the top middle, Brian Propp has Mike Keane. Watch Propp. He just backs away all of a sudden, and now Dave Poulin has to come in and move him out of the way.
Hextall hanging in there. 18 shots have been sent his way, 2 in this period, and both of those just now by Mike Keane. Flyers have 16, 1 in the period, and we played just over 6 minutes. Keane boomed to the boards and glass by Howe, centering pass by Smith, couldn't find Naslund. Poulin over skates, but Samuelson is there and bangs it back out. Chris Chelios with a pass that is sent along for Keane, then to Bobby Smith. Lost to Samuelson, floated back now to Keane, chopped from him by Sutter. Nudged further by Bobby Smith, and Naslund with a pass, and Dave Poulin got back well to cut that off from Keane. Tipped right back out. Svoboda will go back to get it with now 55 seconds to go on the Canadiens power play. 13 minutes, 10 seconds to go in the third. Canadiens leading the series 3-2 in this game, 3-1. It is Chychrun forcing one around that Brian Propp tried to tip further. Prop once more. Floats this one by Chelios. It is jabbed at by Courtnall, but eventually skated down by Pelle Ekblom. Swedish-born forward Pelle Ekblom for the Flyers leads it back up shorthandedly for his team. Here's Ekblom racing along, giving to Karkner. And Karkner flipped one in front that's gloved down by Chelios. And then to Carboneau. I thought that might have been a hand pass, but they rule inadvertent. Puck turned right back out, and it is Karkner once more. Gets it through to Prop. Rob controls, hands over to Karkner. Wanted to get it to Ekblom. Karkner again. Slots one, but that deflected away. And here come the Canadiens out on a 3-on-1. Courtnall moves in, has Robinson. Gives to Walter, he scores! Ryan Walter. And the Canadiens have a 4-1 lead.
Well, Montreal just went back into kind of a zone defense. Now keep in mind, Montreal was on the power play. The power play had ended by the time you pick it up here with Courtnell moving down and dumping back to Ryan Walter. But watch the swat that Ron Hextall tries to lay on Walter right there. He missed him. Brian Propp looks hurt on the play, and you know he's still getting up slowly. But the Flyers had to gamble a bit and go for something at the other end, and this is one of those three-on-ones that I was talking about. Ryan Walter made no mistake. Put that one home. Boy, you could see Brian Propp fell right with his back into the post.
Courtnall gets the only assist on Walter's second of the playoffs, first of the series, and it came 2 seconds after the penalty to Tocchet had ended. So now the walls get even slipperier. Out of the pit from which the Flyers hope to climb. Sinisalo to Murphy, chopped one off high from Ludwig, and then it is scooped up by Gainey, and Gainey just plops one back down. Hextall coming out of his goal to flip this one along to Gord Murphy. 12 minutes to go in the third period. Along to Keith Acton. Acton trying to get through Chelios and can't. Keith Acton along the boards, turned from Chelios. Puck taken away by Richie, lost to Jay Wells, and Wells jammed it back, catching Tocchet offside. But we have a stoppage of play and a penalty coming up. Richie will go sit in the penalty box. The Flyers will have the power play. All that when we return.
Well, this might be the spark the Flyers need. They get to go on the power play. A trip right there. Richie pulled Jay Wells down. It was 0 for 17 coming into tonight.
Right, so it is 0 for 21, going on 22 right now. Puck taken by Mark Howe. And Howe slides it across to Murphy. Murphy's pass along to Eklund. Then back to Murphy again. Up for Howe, chop back down. Chelios working along with Craig Ludwig on defense, and the forwards have changed now. McPhee out with Skrudlin. Belly Eklund trying to bring it ahead, but it's offside, called against the Flyers with 27 seconds gone on this power play and 11:19 to go in the third. Great year for Belly Eklund. My goodness, what a contribution he made to this team, let alone Tim Kerr's splendid year on the power play, assisting on 15 of Kerr's 25 power play goals.
He has really had the jump tonight, too. A lot of people don't understand that the long season with its ins and outs and ups and downs, athletes simply just do not feel the same way on every night. And anybody that works out, anybody that plays a sport knows what I'm talking about. Some days you have it and other days you don't. You can eat the same, sleep the same, and work out the same. Sometimes it just doesn't work out in your favor with the jump, but tonight Kelly Eppen has the jump in his legs.
Howe with a shot, and it got all the way through before being blocked off by Roy. Howe back across to Propp. Dumped back along to McPhee, and he sends it back down. I can't recall when the last time was that I mentioned Roy's name. I think there was one other time in this period, and I'm not sure if in the second at all.
No, the Flyers have been all around it, but Montreal again puts up that stone wall. They get a little piece, a little chunk of every puck that seems to go at them.
Puck dumped right back along, and it is Walter in there to get it. Then Bullard trying to knock it along. And it is forced back out again by Ludwig. Roy is likely recipient of the Vezina Trophy this year. At least we would guess he'd be the outside favorite. Tocca to drive, and that one was wide. Back along it came to be shunted further by Bob Gainey. And ahead now, Guy Carboneau comes. Carboneau, oh, what an effort. Shifted from backhand to forehand and sent one high off Hextall. As the Canadiens are starting to do a little toying, even though they are shorthanded.
Boy, that was a pretty strong move. You know, Carboneau's got one of the longest, nicest strides you'll ever see. He just takes a long glide, and it looks like he's going to his backhand. And as soon as Gord Murphy turned, Carboneau turned and fired. At this stage of the hockey game, you notice that Carboneau didn't bother trying to poke away at that rebound. 4-1 lead. He knows he's going to get a lot of abuse if he tries to jam one by Ron Hextall in tight.
.10-06 left in the third. Flyers power play has 20 seconds to go on it. And Shel Samuelson pivots with this. Samuelson and Howe, Ron Sutter, Mellenby, and Sinisalo. That one knocked away by Corson. Boy, Corson has certainly proved his worth for the Canadiens in this series. And again, as in the case of Derek Smith, this is a guy that doesn't show his worth a lot of times in stats, but he sure has in this series with 5 points. Ahead now, it is sent in on Hextall. Teams are back at even strength. 9 minutes and 35 seconds to go in this third period of play. This is the season for the Flyers, unless they can get three and keep the Canadiens off the board. That would at least force overtime. Puck drilled around, it's swooped by Roy. It has got Mellenby in, drops it back behind to Sutter, cross-bodied by Green. Mellenby can't get to the front, instead it's Corson. Corson rolling it along further. In to get this is Richie, and Richie able to nudge it along, though Mellenby is able to pump it away. Back it comes to Stefan Richie. Hooks it across, and it is Bob Gainey. And Gainey fires one that went off the skate of Shel Samuelson. Howe across to Samuelson, then tries for Eklund. Puck cut off and turned right back by Robinson, and his pass goes back deep. Karkner's there along with Keane.
Montreal still just as tight, killing penalties. Flyers only had 22 seconds of attack zone time. In the Montreal zone, they didn't get a shot on goal. As a matter of fact, the Flyers have won this period on Patrick Waugh.
In the old days, shopping for car insurance meant going to company after company, filling out form after form, and getting quotes one at a time. Today, you go to one place, Progressive.com.
You get the Progressive Direct rate plus those other companies' rates in about 8 minutes. It's that simple. Start at progressive.com and get all the information you need to make the best decision in about 8 minutes. Go to progressive.com today.
Every Stanley Cup final has thrilling moments, but perhaps none more memorable than a Game 7 for the right to hoist Lord Stanley.
The waiting is over!
Now, with the Game 7 Collection DVD box set, you can relive these unforgettable contests.
And after 22 years, Raymond Bourque!
Hosted by Craig Simpson. Available wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
Is this the year the Cup comes to Buffalo?
To Carolina?
To Pittsburgh?
Is this the year someone scores 50 in 38?
In 37?
In 36? Is this the year someone scores 200 points?
Is this the year kids start taping their sticks like Stahl?
Is this the year someone scores 93?
Is this the year a forward becomes unstoppable?
Is this the year a goalie stops everything?
Is this the year we finally figure out who's dad's favorite?
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
Этот год?
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
Gotten one shot in 11 and a half minutes of this third period. One shot in 11 and a half minutes. And by repeating that stat, that is not a criticism of the Flyers. That just shows what Montreal has been able to do, as Bill was pointing out, once they get the lead. Here is a pass in. Oh, a quick shot by Mats Naslund. Ricocheted off Bullard and was wide. Acton back across now to Tockett. Shovels went up the wing for Bullard. Tockett able to keep play alive for the Flyers and jabbed one that was knocked down by the defense. Bobby Smith will bring it back up ice. Along to Naslund and then back to Jeff Chychrun. 7:50 to go here in the third period. In case you're just joining us, Montreal has the lead in the game 4-1. They were trailing 1-0 when Scott Mellenby registered for the Flyers at 12:49 of the first. So that put them down one zip. But then on a freaky play in which Jeff Chychrun had actually out of a broken play, directed the puck toward his own net. It went in off of a Canadian who was right nearby Chychrun, Mike Keane, and that was a 1-1 tie after one. Smith and Chelios scored in the second, Walter here in the third, and from the time that the Canadians got the 3-1 lead, they really started to tighten things up. Murphy, a shot off of Poulin, and it trickled wide. Dumped right back along, and Lemieux can't reach it. It's kept alive by Jay Wells. Dumped back over to Poulin. Finessed the slot, but Chelios was there. Now Murphy waiting. Hands back over to Poulin. Poulin with a pass, and Jay Wells will get that one. Wells winds, Chelios takes. Drops it back off, and Lemieux swats it further. Canadians, meanwhile, have 5 shots on goal in this period to the Flyers 1. Courtnall with a pass back up the wing. And it is Guy Carboneau moving by. Carboneau pivots, checked to the corner by Mark Howe. Punched along, and Walter is there. Tries to center, but that ricocheted back over to Sinisalo. Ilkka Sinisalo's pass came right onto the stick of Rick Green. 6.5 to go in the third. Mark Howe is there. And across to Murphy. Murphy trying to get away. Locks up on the puck with Walter. Puck forced away by Courtnall off of Howe. Scott Mellenby starts ahead. Then on to Brian Propp. Drops one to the corner. Ron Sutter goes in. Sutter centers, and Propp scores! Brian Propp has gotten the Flyers back to within 2.
Well, maybe some of those chances in tight are going to start getting through now. The Flyers have had a lot of pressure on Montreal. But Montreal finally gives Brian Propp enough room to put one home, and the Montreal Canadiens are guilty of just poor coverage in front. Rick Green moves on right through, and you can see Guy Carboneau, their ace defensive center. They move to the close post instead of staying off the far post, and Ron Sutter makes a super pass out to Brian Propp. Bingo. When they work, do they ever look easy? 4-2, 6 minutes to go. Still time.
Sutter gets one assist, and Mellenby gets the other at 13:55. So the Flyers have a sniff. They are back to within two. Samuelson takes it. The clock ticks down to 5:45. Markow with this one. Sales one that went all the way back down, and Robinson goes to get it. It was off a Flyer, so no icing. Robinson nearly wiped out, but recovered enough to tip it back further. Now here is Gainey trying to force it by Markow. Gainey and Samuelson go heavily to the boards. Acton to take this. The forechecker is Corson. The puck followed up by Keith Acton again and has Mike Bullard ahead, but the pass trickled right over to Eric Desjardins, the rookie defenseman for the Canadiens. And Desjardins forces play back. 5:10 to go in the third as Samuelson takes a look back up ice and hands over to Karkner. And Terry Karkner spins it around the boards. Rouault tends back over to Chris Chelios. Chelios just by the glove reach of Karkner. Chychrun going back and Naslund there. Chychrun puts the stick into him and Naslund nearly muscled one home. It is Prop battling behind her. Check that, Dave Poulin. Poulin locks up and Karkner nearby too. Flyers trying to get control and start out. Derek Smith with a pass to Karkner, but that's stolen by Naslund and dropped back in. 4 minutes, 35 seconds left in this third period. Shots are 5-2, Montreal, with 15 and a half minutes having been played. Canadiens guilty of icing. Karkner touches, back it'll come near Rouault when we come back.
4:20 to go, 4-2 Montreal leads. This is it. The Flyers are facing elimination. Trying to stay alive. Ron Sutter is out there for the draw. Flyers win it.
Here's Jay Wells. Back off for Prop, but instead it's Mellenby. Mellenby hit hard in the corner by Ryan Walter. Two aside go barreling in, and then Mellenby with a little extra shove on Walter, and a crowd gathers. Well, Bill, you nailed it right. There have been no fights in this game tonight. Only one fight, really, in the whole series. More important things to deal with here. Flyers have had 45 minors, one major, one misconduct, and Montreal has had 36 minors with a major and a misconduct. Power plays are even at five. Montreal with two power play goals. What stands as the winner at this point was Chris Chelios' goal late in the second. But the Flyers will see what they can do about that. Flyers are 0 for 24 on the power play in the series, and will likely not get a power play the rest of this game. Canadiens a very disciplined unit, just not likely to commit any more fouls that would give the Flyers that extra chance of drawing to within one. As you see, Chris Chelios lined up right near Brian Prop. Sutter will have Prop on his left, Mellenby on the right, Murphy and Wells in back. And of course, there's no saving for tomorrow. So Ron Hextall, even though the Flyers are trailing by two rather than the customary one, will likely be pulled as we near the end if the score hasn't changed. Here's Wells with a pass. Dropped to Mellenby. Popped one high in the air. Went off the glass. Dropped near Sutter. Locked up by Chelios. Puck turned to the back of the net by Walter. Sutter able to burrow loose. And there are just plenty of Canadiens at the goal mouth to prevent any pass getting through. Now it is Wells dropping one off the glass back deep. Chris Chelios to get that. Whoa, was he ever hit by Ron Sutter? And that is going to cost the Flyers at a time when they don't need a minor.
Hockey Fights Cancer has raised more than $9 million for cancer care, research, and awareness.
Don't give up.
Join our hockey family in the fight against cancer. Log on to NHL.com and join the fight.
Don't give up.
For 40 years, the Pittsburgh Penguins have provided some of the NHL's most unforgettable moments. And now you can relive them with the Penguins' 10 Greatest Games box set, as voted on by the fans.
Just moves in towards the goaltender, shoots, and he scores!
Hosted by Mike Lang, the original broadcasts capture all the amazing action.
Oh, you'd have to be here to believe it!
Available wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
In this jersey, I pledge to wreak havoc on my opponent's plus-minus.
To make one-timers happen way more than once.
I pledge that my team will scrap for every single point on the schedule.
In this jersey, I pledge that holes are only holes if they're open.
Shop.nhl.com presents the RBK Edge jersey. All 30 teams reinvented for more strength, more speed, more belief.
In this jersey, I pledge to play for the logo on the front, not the name on the back.
What do you pledge? Visit shop.nhl.com for your jersey.
Watch Ovechkin fly like Bure. See Finneran smash like Stevens.
Malkin! Sensational!
In a new generation of NHL stars, there are remnants of the past. The Just Like Me DVD shows how a new group of heroes is influenced by hockey's greatest generation.
You want to talk about good young talent?
Available January 22nd wherever DVDs are sold or shop NHL.com.
Oh my goodness!
Hi, I'm Sidney Crosby, and when I'm home, I'm watching the NHL Network.
You're going to see a whole bunch of frustration end up right on top of Chris Chelios. Watch this hit. Ron Sutter cleans Chris Chelios' clock, but it cost the Flyers a two-minute minor with 3:42 to go. So the big X that was the mark on Chris Chelios was a target for Ron Sutter. But boy, oh boy, that really takes care of two valuable minutes.
Yeah, it's strange too, as one of the hallmarks of the Flyers in this playoff series being disciplined, that it was broken that time, but they'll have to deal with something more here in these last 3 minutes and 42 seconds. They need two to force overtime. They'll be dealing with what will likely be a pretty conservative power play for Montreal.
I guess it'll be a prevent defense kind of power play. Yeah. They're just going to sag back and not do anything really creative.
Howe and Prop, Samuelson and Dave Poulin. That'll be the four players that are out.
Another look at the hit.
Flyers were really fortunate that there wasn't an injury to Chelios on that play, because the stick was involved and they would be shorthanded the rest of regulation time. Okay, off the faceoff, it is Howe back to Samuelson. The Canadiens will go with Corson, Gainey, and Skrudland. And I guess that tells you how conservative they're being up front. These are not the gunners, these are the checkers. Puck muscled along by Corson. Sprawling is Brian Propp. Gainey trying to work it along, and then he held on to Dave Poulin's stick as the puck loose. Right back to Bob Gainey it comes. Sent to the point, and it's Robinson with a pass that is chipped away. Brought back up by Propp, but then lost just that quickly. Corson taken to the wall by Samuelson, and Mark Howe works in on Skrudland, but Skrudland emerges, trying to turn away from Howe. Brian Skrudland right back over for Corson. Plays some catch with Skrudland, works to the outside to Robinson, then back over to Desjardins, a shot, stick save, Hextall. Rebound, work back to Desjardins again. A minute 10 to go on the power play, 2:50 left in the third. Desjardins moves in, fires, and that one trapped by Hextall, and he waits. 2:46 to go in the game. 1:04 left on the minor penalty that was assessed to Sutter.
You got to know that the Montreal forwards are thinking, boy, if I get close enough to Ron Hextall, my life might end right here. Ron Hextall is a proud athlete, and all his frustrations sometimes come out through his stick. There's the save.
Many of the fans have left, but not a majority. A lot of them will stay around, and if the situation still is hopeless, you'll likely hear quite an ovation here in the final seconds. This team has provided the locals here with a lot of thrills this year. In the regular season, a great deal of uncertainty. This was a team that had an awful November and an impressive December. They ended up 500, and were not, by Philadelphia standards, a very great team. But boy, did they surprise when it came playoff time. Naslund then back to Smith. Tried to center, and it is held off by Ron Hextall for another stoppage of play with 48 seconds of power play time to go. So the scoreboard clock will read 1 minute and 42 seconds left when this power play is over, unless the Canadians score, of course. So that would be 102 seconds the Flyers would have in which to get a couple.
But that big red, white, and blue machine is ticking pretty good right now.
Svoboda drive and a stick save made by Hextall. Worked back out by Keith Acton. And it is Roy tending it for Svoboda. Svoboda able to start it back up now with 2 minutes and 12 seconds to go. And the penalty time is down now to the last 25. Hextall stops it. And Ron Hextall just controls with his stick. He's penalty killing as he does this. Turns it along to Poulin. Canadians had already dropped back, anticipating what Hextall would do. Green, Svoboda. Naslund across to Bobby Smith. Wingers are wide, and here comes Mats Naslund. Moving right in, he couldn't shove it by. Hextall knocked it down and then was able to clear. Out of the penalty box comes Sutter, offside against the Canadians, and now Hextall goes barreling out at one of the Canadians,
Chris
hitting
Chelios
high and hard.
He wanted Chris Chelios as soon as Chelios came across the blue line. And that has to be that big mark that we talked about that's still riding on Chris Chelios' shirt from that hit on Brian Propp in game one. That's pretty well a signal that Ron Hextall has kissed the season goodbye. A minute and 37 seconds to go. The Flyers are down by two, and Hextall made a beeline for Chelios. And you know what was interesting about the play was that Chelios just came across the blue line intentionally to stop play, to end up with an intentional offside.
This would have been the point at which the Flyers would have wound up even strength with the Canadians, and Hextall might have been pulled in very soon for an extra attacker. Chelios escorted to the bench where the Canadiens greet him, but there you see Ron Hextall frustrated, and now Dave Poulin is catching some hits from one of the Canadiens, so Samuelson moved in, and we have a real powder keg brewing here.
You bet. Boy, did Chel Samuelson ever land a straight left on Bobby Smith, too. Acton and Ludwig move in now. Ludwig is a lot bigger and stronger than Keith Acton, so he pulled Acton into the pile.
Keep in mind now that Chelios has left, and if I count right, the Canadiens have one fewer on the ice than the Flyers, and Hextall is being restrained by Gerard Gauthier from getting over toward Patrick Roy.
Hextall is also being challenged by Patrick Roy. Roy threw his stick down, took his mask off, and said, "You want me? Come over here." Now Paul Holmgren's leaning over the bench. It looked as if he was motioning to Ron Hextall to come over. As much as this would have been Paul Holmgren's style when he played, we have seen a lot more restraint from Paul Holmgren as a coach. So you'd have to think that this wasn't his idea.
Two splendid teams with skill and heart and desire, and from that standpoint, it has been a storybook series. A couple of shutouts by Patrick Roy and strong defensive play by Montreal. Tremendous emotional surge for the Flyers in games one and five. And this type of thing should not be the final chapter in that storybook.
The old story of losing the war but trying to get a couple of battle wins in before it's all over. And hey, the Flyers play that kind of brand of hockey. But they kissed this one goodbye with Ron Sutter's penalty on Chris Chelios. And now have fully said goodbye to it with a minute and 37 seconds to go, down 4-2 to Montreal. So all of that pride manifested itself in a pretty violent way late in this game. But Montreal will move on to play the Calgary Flames, barring a miracle. I mean, a minute and 37 seconds to go. You got to think the Flyers are going to be shorthanded.
Yo, what's up, y'all? This is your disaster supply kit. You need this, all right? This is your family first aid kit. You're going to need some water. Do the medicine. This man important right here, dog. Flashlight is necessary. Very important. Food. Batteries are very important. I would always carry a little radio.
Minutes into the second period, and the Detroit Red Wings lead the Montreal Canadiens 3-2.
The game has changed. So should the way you watch it.
A great day of hockey.
NHL Network, the home of hockey. Available in HD.
Is this the year the Cup comes to Buffalo?
To Carolina?
To Pittsburgh?
Is this the year someone scores 50 in 38?
In 37?
In 36? Is this the year someone scores 200 points?
Is this the year kids start taping their sticks like Stahl?
Is this the year someone scores 93?
Is this the year a forward becomes unstoppable?
Is this the year a goalie stops everything?
Is this the year we finally figure out who's dad's favorite?
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
Этот год?
Is this the year?
Is this the year?
Hi, I'm Sidney Crosby, and when I'm home, I'm watching the NHL Network.
Now the game will continue with Ron Sutter, Tim Kerr, Rick Tocchet, Mark Howe, and Brian Propp. The Muckers, the Gunners, they're all out there for the Flyers in this last-ditch effort.
Well, now Montreal only has four men out. The Flyers have five. That's right. Ken Reagan is out, so it's the numerical advantage, but both teams have guys in the penalty box.
Ryan Walter will be up front along with Carboneau, and the defensemen will be Robinson and Green. They go with the two most experienced. Flyers need 97 seconds in which to do it. Off the face-off, the puck came to Roy, and he sails one all the way back down the ice. This will be icing as Brian Propp goes back to get it. And immediately you wonder, in this Hextallian era, whether Roy was thinking about sniping one there or not.
Boy, I don't know what kind of lane he had. I'm not sure that it was open all the way up the middle. But I would think that Patrick Roy was concentrating just on getting that puck out of the zone.
He succeeded in getting 10 seconds off the scoreboard, so now it's a minute 27 to go here in the third.
Tim Kerr is out there. He found out yesterday that his thumb is in fact fractured. No freezing, he's playing with it anyway.
Moving back for this is Mark Howe. 1 minute and 20 seconds to go. Here is Howe with a pass off for Kerr, but that came through to Rick Green. Shoveled it back along and that flipped to Howe. But it is Larry Robinson in the last minute 10. Dumps it back off and Kartner takes over. Kartner trying to bring it through. Feeds a pass on to Mark Howe. Howe centered one, that went off the skate of Green. Still they battle back behind the goal. Trying to reach it is Carboneau. Up with it is Ron Sutter. Yanks it on to Howe. Checked by Green. Robinson floats one off and Ryan Walter is there with that one. Tried to pop it on further. Denied by Kartner and then rolled one on. Carboneau trying to get to it. Backhands one that goes wide. No icing because he was well across the red line. So in the last 33 seconds of the season, unless the Flyers get to it, it's Kerr. Kerr headed back behind the net. Pivots and takes a look. He's got Murphy and gives to him. Murphy angles one back off to Mike Bullard. Centered one, and Tockett had a piece of it. Another pass back to Murphy, and he tried to work one toward the net, but it was blocked away. Kerr overskates, then Reek Rathers. His shot went off of Ludwig. 10 seconds to go. It's rolled back along to Gord Murphy, and now the fans has won. Rise and applaud as the season comes to a close for the Philadelphia Flyers. The Canadiens will move on for the fifth All-Canada Stanley Cup Final in the last 50 years, while the Flyers will end the season.
The Canadiens advanced to the Stanley Cup Final, where they lost to the Calgary Flames in 6 games. As for the Flyers, this would signal the start of a decline. Nobody could have imagined it at the time, but this turned out to be their last playoff game for 6 years. Thanks for watching Vintage Games here on the NHL Network. We'll see you again next time.